I'm Lisa Anderson, a director of Young Adults for Focus on the Family, an international ministry dedicated really to helping families thrive in Christ. And I head up Boundless, our young adult ministry at boundless.org, and I'm host of The Boundless Show, which is a weekly podcast and radio show for college through 30-somethings, mostly single. It's funny because working with a lot of young adults now, you know, and young adults are criticized of being so entitled and having everything delivered to them. I feel like sometimes I'm that old person, you know, kind of being like, these young kids, because I grew up, I remember we were quite poor. My parents had been missionaries, my dad a pastor, and we did a cross-country move to move out to California from northern Minnesota. So totally, two totally different worlds. And we made that move in a sinus infection green station wagon. So it was this terrible, terrible shade of green with a homemade car top carrier, so to fit all of our luggage. And then we pulled all of our possessions in a pig trailer that a farmer had lent to us. And we made our trip across the U.S. to start a life in California where my parents didn't have jobs. We didn't even stay in motels along the way because we didn't have money. So we stayed in rest areas and in state parks pretty much. And but my parents were just trusting the Lord that God had something for them out there because they had been missionaries in the Philippines and had been contacted by some Filipino friends in California that their families were falling apart. They needed help. They needed biblical guidance. And would my parents come out and help them, especially their kids, kind of reorient them to things of faith? And so my parents took that as a call from the Lord, and we moved out there. And it was really a lesson to me in faithfulness and in not, you know, both my parents really taught me that what God has for us is always first, and we don't need to pursue success, and we don't need to pursue our own fame or our own name. And I became so tempted by that in high school and into college because I started doing well in school and getting opportunities for universities and really telling, having people tell me, Lisa, you know, you can be something, you can be something. And so thankfully, my parents, with the moorings of Scripture, really reminded me, even in incidents like that, that, you know what, put God first and the rest will follow. I think young adults feel so dismissed. And so, you know, if a young adult's given the opportunity to say, wow, you know, what would I recommend you do differently in parenting? I think a few things from what I hear from young adults, a few things come to mind. The first is, make me do hard things and let me fail at them. And so there are so many parents, we've heard the terms maybe of helicopter parenting, where the parents who are being too controlling of a young adult's lives, or parents who are being too controlling of a young adult's life. And then now the new term is lawnmower parenting, where parents are clearing out all the obstacles in front of their children so that they do not have to fail. And those are really problematic, not just for kids that are going through that, but for the young adults as they now have to enter adulthood and they're going to be called to fend for themselves and they don't have the skills to do that. And so I think young adults are kind of, you know, clandestinely crying out, no, please make me do hard stuff so I understand the real world and I understand how to grow up, take responsibility for myself. And then if I need to fail, let me fail. I remember a mom telling me one time when I was speaking to a group of parents, and she said, yeah, she said, my daughter called me. She'd had a fender bender, and she actually put me on the phone to apologize to the guy that she hit. And she said, shame on me. I actually did it for her. Rather than making her own the fact that she hit a guy, and then I went and paid the bill for it and didn't make her work to pay it off. And she was just telling on herself that this is kind of the, you know, she was so embarrassed on behalf of her daughter that she didn't make her do that. I remember another mom telling me that she had written her son's essays for his college applications because he just didn't know how to, and was just helping him get into college. And I'm like, you are not preparing your children for what they need to know and what they need to do in the real world. And so I think young adults, there's so much potential with young adults. They're eager. I mean, this generation, millennials, are very responsible, very nimble in what they know, what they can do, and they want to be given challenges. And I think so many parents parents, all this sheltering of young adults, I blame it often on the parents who are unwilling to let go, unwilling to become empty nesters because they're fearful of their next season. And so it's like, parents, you got to be willing to cut those apron strings and let your kids go. Let them grow up. Let them transition into that friend role with you, where you're still going to be their mentor. You're still going to be someone they come to for advice, but you no longer need to hold their hand and move on. Another thing I think young adults would say to parents is, live out your faith every day with me, not just on Sunday. My generation, I think, is the generation where it was like, okay, put your kids in youth group, make sure they get in church, and they're going to turn out okay. And we're seeing now that that's not the case. Parents who actually show struggle in their own lives day to day, you have a financial problem, you bring it to the Lord. You commit it to show that you are questioning your faith, that you're crying out to God, that you're struggling, to show Monday through Friday, Monday through Saturday, that your faith makes a difference in your life. Because just showing up on Sunday, just doing church and then throwing the Bible on the counter when you come in and going back to business as usual, that doesn't show a dependence on God that's going to take a young adult through the tough times. And so parents need to be willing to model dependent faith on the Lord and a faith that really goes the distance. And I think they'll do well by their kids. And I think the third thing young adults would say is, please show me a real, a messy, but a loving marriage. And so I think so many parents want to protect their kids from conflict, from marital problems, from maybe some discord within family relationships. And young adults are like, I need to know that you can do marriage, that it can be problematic, it can be messy, it can be hard, but that you can still stay married through all of that. Because right now we're in such an era of disposable relationships where people are like, you know what, maybe I just didn't choose the right person. Maybe I just didn't know exactly what I was getting into. Maybe this person changed or I changed. And we know that you can obviously ebb and flow in relationships, but the marriages that go 40, 50, 60 years are the ones that have mastered compromise and sacrifice. And those are all things that can be taught now as kids are growing up, as kids are learning to choose others above themselves. Any kid should be able to give up of their time, maybe give up of their allowance, give up of things that are important to them to help others out. And not only will that help them going into marriage, but it's just going to help them in life to be Jesus reflecting people, to be people that truly care about others and really are ambassadors of Christ in the way that they live. So many young adults are the victims of broken homes, and they have grown up without a father, or they've grown up being ping-ponged between homes, and they don't really understand the construct of an intact family, and they're not sure moving forward what that even looks like. And I think one thing that is good for parents to inspire their kids with, if they themselves have gone through a divorce and that's been part of their story, is to realize that, first of all, this is not the fault of the children. It's not the kids' problem. It's not the family disintegrating because of unknown means or because of, oh, we just couldn't make it work. There are obviously reasons why divorce happens, but the kids don't have to think that this will be something that, one, they're responsible, and two, that one, they're responsible for, and two, they're going to have to take all the burden of moving forward. The other thing I think parents can really inspire their kids with is the fact that they have the power to break the cycle of divorce in their own families. I have friends, in fact, that are the first couple, as they've gotten married, the first couple to remain in an intact marriage for more than a decade, for example. Parents have been divorced, grandparents have been divorced, aunts and uncles divorced, and they have realized that, you know what, I have to take responsibility for my relationship, and I have to get all the help that's available out there to make this work. But I am able to, by the power of the Holy Spirit and with the support structures that are around me. And I love the empowerment in that of, like, I can break this cycle. This doesn't have to be my story. This doesn't have to be, God is a big fan of marriage, and God puts people together. He puts people in families, and he loves being in in the business of making great matches, and he's about doing that. And we just have to lean in hard, trust him, realize that marriage really isn't about us anyway. It's a picture of Christ and his church, and it's a covenant. And when we go in with that mindset, that's covenantal and committed rather than disposable or kind of consumeristic of what can this person do for me, I think it gives young adults a better mindset to start the race and realize that it truly is a journey and not just a destination. I think the first thing that parents can do to help their children discern right from wrong is to preach in their homes directly from the scriptures. If their kids don't know what is biblical truth and what isn't, there is no blueprint, there is no sounding board, there's no compass for how they make moral choices. So that has to be understood in the home. But not only does it have to be taught and understood, it has to be modeled. If parents aren't making decisions, hard decisions, by the truths of scripture, if they're kind of fudging the truth when they have the opportunity, if they're kind of cheating on their taxes, if they're making decisions that are convenient rather than truly biblically accurate and God-honoring, then what motivation is there for their children to make such decisions themselves? So, first kids have to know right from wrong, then they have to see that it matters in the lives of their parents. A parent's biggest fears is, what if I look, 10, 15 years ahead, where is my young adult going to be? And I'm so fearful because I don't want them to have made mistakes. Maybe they're mistakes I made, or maybe they're mistakes I'm fearing for them. I see the culture and what they're prey to kind of in the friend circles they're in and beyond, or with media and Hollywood. And I think a parent's first line of defense has to be prayer. I know for my sister, for example, she said, I feel like I'm not a great parent, but the one thing I can do is pray for my kids. And, she'll say, I made a number of mistakes, and goodness gracious, at times I was like way too hovering and way too invasive in my kids' lives. Other times I was too hands off. Other times, I had to let them go to school every day, and who knows what they're learning there. But she said, I prayed. And, God is the one who loves your kids more than you do. He's the one who has his hand on them. He's the one who can actually control their circumstances. So that has to be first. So many young adults feel left out in our culture today. And it's weird because millennials are actually the biggest generation now. So you would think, oh, aren't they just taking over? But especially in the church, single young adults feel a little bit left behind. Churches are programmed largely for families. There's so much for marriages there and for kids. And you look in any bulletin, and it's like, let's tell you what to do with your family. And then singles are kind of left out. And I think it's great for Boundless to be able to have the opportunity to be that place of not only content, but community for young adults who are trying to navigate all this space and they feel so alone in it. And maybe they're getting pressure from their families or from the culture to kind of be something different, or whether it's be successful or be married or be rich, be famous. And we have the opportunity to really speak to them directly and say, we're here for you. And one thing we're super passionate about is turning them back to the local church, because we say, we're here, we've got advice for you, we have content for you, we have we're going to put our arm around your shoulder, we're going to root for you, but we are not your church. You need to be in a local body of believers who are going to be up in your face, holding you accountable, making you serve, making you plug in, making you grow up and be part of the family of God. But you have the ability to do that. You are an adult. You are a contributor, not a consumer. And so Boundless is just privileged to be there to help them along the way as they really navigate maturity, move into adulthood, take ownership of their faith, move out from under their parents' spiritual shadow, live out a biblical worldview, date with purpose, and prepare for marriage and family. And so we invite anyone along, any young adult who says, I just need a space to be me, to ask some of my questions, to feel like I matter in the church, that I matter in the family. And, singleness is not a waiting room for marriage. We're not telling singles, oh, just bide your time, and then when you're married, you can really start serving God. No, the time for you to start serving is right now. God has something for you to do. There is a mission field out there for you. And so grab hold of it now and embrace it with joy.
God is love, and love comes from God. In 1 John, the Bible tells us that God is not only all loving, but that He actually is love itself. The heart of the Parent Compass television show is to bring the transforming love of God to families everywhere. In every Parent Compass episode, true stories reveal family struggles and how their lives were radically changed by the love of God. Parent Compass, an award-winning television series, is completely funded by people like you. If you have been touched by God and you want to share God's love to others, would you please pass it on? Jesus tells us to go into all the world and to tell about Him. With your donation, you allow us to take this television show into many different nations and in many different languages, free of charge. And a portion of your donation goes to Parent Compass Outreach to feed starving children. Your gift does so much. To make your tax-deductible gift, go to parentcompass.tv/donate. That's parentcompass.tv/donate. And thank you for sending love and hope around the world.